Alex Silva in the bright yellow trunks, Balart in the blue. Outside leg kick from Balart, right hand from Silva, both missing.
Yeah, Balart likes to mix in those leg kicks with the hands. He's been working a lot on his boxing out there in Florida. He spends a lot of time out there at ATT.
Alex faking with the jab. Out of southpaw stance is Alex, so too Gustavo. High left roundhouse there from Silva. Overhand left, powered up on that one. Good Gustavo Balart.
Yeah, reached way back into his back pocket to throw that big old left hand. He likes to set that left hand up with the low kicks. You can watch him go inside with his lead leg and then just wind up and throw that big right hand. There it is, the first attempt on a takedown. That's gonna be Alex's puzzle to solve. He needs to figure out Alex throwing a spinning heel kick with some new striking tools.
Uppercut from Gustavo off the left hand. There's the overhand left again. Doesn't want to go to the well one time too many with that overhand left, lest Alex reads it and shoots him for a takedown.
Yeah, Alex needs to keep his hands up, though. He doesn't want to get too fancy. I know he's been spending a lot of time out there at Evolve Mixed Martial Arts training with the strawweight world champion, Xiongxing Nan, who has been sharpening his hands and really working on his striking.
Overhand left again. Oh, Alex, nicely done.
That's what Alex wanted. He wanted to pull guard. Now he's going after the leg. Leg entanglement, looking for the heel hook. Let's see if he can drag the Cuban wrestler down. Chooses to try to backpack him. Good job by Balart. He needs to try to free that leg. He needs to create some space. It turns out he does just that. Good job from Gustavo Balart.
Clever work from the Cuban. 3 minutes 15 remaining, first round.
Alex
looking
Silva
through the brow, Alex Silva, uppercut there from Balart, throws a knee to the midsection, doesn't connect, little body shot from the Cuban on the inside.
Silva's doing a good job of entering different types of takedowns. I wouldn't be surprised if he pulls guard right here. He's got the overhook, that whizzer on his right side. He can possibly use this to set up something, but it's hard to take down Gustavo Balart because he's got such a low center of gravity.
Balart, the Greco-Roman wrestler, represented Cuba in the Olympic Games. Two-punch combination there from the Cuban.
Nice little touches there by Balart. Exchanging inside the clinch.
Gustavo had an eight-week camp, said he worked on his jiu-jitsu. Says he developed a good guillotine, a good heel hook, and an arm triangle. Will he get the chance to slap one on Alex Silva tonight? Says Alex doesn't have any good striking, only good jiu-jitsu.
I don't see that really happening, but he could hurt him, you know, force a shot from Alex and then catch one of those guillotines. I've seen that in the past from Gustavo, but in this instance, I think he's gonna wanna keep it on the feet, beat up that lead leg, and really try to look to land that big old left hook of his.
It's the body shot off the lead, the overhand left off the back.
There it is again.
Inside leg to overhand left from Balart. That's the money shot tonight for Gustavo Balart. Well, so far in the first round, spinning heel kick there from Alex. We haven't seen the flying knee attempts yet from Gustavo.
Alex is looking for that wheel kick. Nice little body shot landed by Balart there. Alex has got to keep his hands up, though. Stay tight with his boxing.
Alex's hands are low at the moment. Gustavo's are up high. Circling away from Alex's power side. Jumping front kick there from Alex.
Nice little leg entry right there. Silva looks to angle the legs. But that was a nice little escape right there from Gustavo. But Alex went after the other leg. Really aggressively looking for a heel hook now.
And Alex Silva find the finish on Gustavo Balart with 1-5 remaining. First round set for 3.
Gustavo's got to start fighting those hands. He can't allow Silva to extend it, which he's doing right now. He's got to put the foot on the hips and start to push away. The knee's almost out of danger. You can see him trying to kick, but you can't keep a grounded opponent. You can knee a grounded opponent. There's the heel hook. There's the heel hook.
Referee Herb Dean right on top of it. Gustavo.
Belly down, let's go.
Defending
here. Belly down. He's going to try to go belly down. So it's very important that Balart fights those hands and doesn't get extended. He's got to try to push. He's got to try to spin or at least keep that foot flat on the ground.
Alex Silva hunting for a finish. 25 seconds to go. Hammer fist strike off the left hand there from Gustavo.
And I'll tell you from personal experience, it is terrifying to have Alex Silva start attacking your legs. He's so slick. Here he goes, cross Ashi into the heel hook. Let's see if he can get it. Good job by Balart. Balart's got those, you know, short legs, so it's hard to really get a hold of him.
It looks like we're going to go into the second round and a chance to restart from the stand-up for Gustavo Balart.
Ooh, dangerous pass. Good job by Balart to survive, but I like the aggressiveness of Alex Silva looking for the submissions, trying to find creative ways to get him, to engage with him on the ground. Here's these nice little inside leg kicks, and there's a big right, left hand rather, that landed on the lat of Alex Silva. Here's Alex Silva trying to change things up, enter into the pocket, but a nice little uppercut, little short little pop right there, landed by Balart. Here's another nice little right hook. Some shots are scoring for the Gladiador.
Find the distance, okay? I need you to keep your guard up. Other than that, Alex, jiu-jitsu is beautiful. Keep it up, go for the leg lock, get on top, let's go, let's go.
Encouraging words in the corner from Evolve MMA for Alex Silva.
That's
the circle door about to close.
That's one veteran right there, Adam Kayum. He's been in the circle. He knows what to do. He's the new head coach over there at Evolve Mixed Martial Arts. And Alex Silva, some words of advice. Let's see if he can get it.
Herb Dean kicks us off. Second round of three. Orthodox stance on Silva, southpaw on Balart. Balart's been working the overhand left all night so far.
Yeah, I expect Balart to go back to that leg kick and really start setting up that big old left hand. He needs to give him a little something different. I know those are his two main weapons because he had a reach disadvantage. So that inside leg kick just kind of keeps scoring. Ooh, he goes to the outside with a nice scoring technique right there. Forces Alex Silva to change things up, go back to orthodox.
Balart always full of confidence when we talk to him.
Good sprawl, good sprawl. It's really hard to take down Balart with conventional takedown attempts like single legs and double legs. So you really have to change things up. So I can see Alex with a shot and then he immediately started to pull guard. Now he's got Alex Balart in his half, in his butterfly guard. Let's see what he can do with it. Tries to sweep, goes to full guard. Balart's gonna try to posture up here and drop a little bit of ground and pound.
You see the strawweight world champion Zhong Jinan looking on in the corner there of Alex Silva. This is right in front of Silva's team. They are barking instructions across the circle in the corner of Gustavo Balart.
Silva's looking to attack the left arm of Balart. Balart's gotta be careful here. He doesn't want to get his body extended or his arm locked up. Nice little sprawl there. Move his arm out of danger. This is where Balart needs to do work. He needs to go to work with the ground and pound. Start to damage Silva on the ground. Get him to start thinking twice about being in bottom position. He's got him pressed up against the wall, so it's gonna kind of limit Alex's ability to break the submissions. But he's got one butterfly hook to possibly sweep, but he chooses to abandon it and stand back up.
Balart back on his feet here, El Gladiador. Will he throw that overhand left? Inside leg kick. There's the overhand left, backs off Alex Silva. Jab from El Gladiador, goes to the body. Silva fires out a front kick.
If Silva could time possibly a knee when Gustavo tries to enter the pocket like that, because you can see him winding up and he dips his head way down when he enters in to throw those big shots, because he has to close the distance and he has to do it really fast. That was a nice little touch right there, landed by Balart. If Silva could time a knee on the entry, just to start getting Balart to think about that entry, it could change things up.
Body shot from Gustavo, hook to hook, off both hands there from the Cuban.
The left hand scored right there for Balart.
Alex very side on stance here, turning back kick to the midsection.
Spin kicks are a new addition to Silva's arsenal. I like the changeup.
Has he thrown any of those at you in sparring, Dragon?
No.
I'm going to ask him to, you know that. Gustavo setting that left hand and he sets it with an outside thigh kick. As the Dragon said, trying to switch up the approach. And again, that's almost lead hand to the overhand left from Gustavo.
That's good. That's a good little changeup right there. He goes to the uppercut to the hook, right? And then he throws the inside leg kick to the hook. But he's also kind of setting a pattern for himself. Silva needs to figure out the patterns that Balart's doing because he's got to answer it. Because on the feet, he's kind of getting touched up, Michael.
Turning back kick there from Gustavo Balart. Alex skipping punt kick. Curls the left hand over the top of the right shoulder to Gustavo. Alex an outside thigh kick. takes one back. And another one there from Balart, trying to tenderize those. Quadriceps of the right leg. Alex shifts out of southpaw, goes to orthodox stance, protects that leg from getting kicked.
All those little touches, though, are scoring. You know, a lot of the kicks coming back from Alex are being caught on the arms from Balart, and he's able to defend a lot of the strikes coming back from Alex. But those leg kicks are really starting to score a lot of points for Balart.
Been a good succession of leg kicks off the back leg of Gustavo Balart. Faking with that lead hand, Gustavo. Hasn't thrown that overhand left lately. There it is now on the inside. Glancing hook from Gustavo, good left hand. A jaw retlock.
Yeah, Alex is starting to get frustrated. You can see him. Oh, that's a nice little short little punch right there.
Gustavo felt it, shook his head. You know that hurt him. Alex trying to thread the right hand. Moves in for an elbow. Spinny heel kick, a little too close there for Alex. There's a step up elbow, nicely done. Muay Thai clinch, high knee from Alex, crossing elbow. Some Muay Thai to end the round from Alex Silva.
Alex's striking does look better when he actually goes. When he actually initiates and goes first, he's able to score and he looks relaxed. His striking is improved. But Balart is scoring with these. It's these flurries, it's these quick little flashes. He rushes forward, boom, boom, three hit combinations, and then he's gone. He's back to resetting, and then he's able to do it again. When Alex starts to go and he closes that distance, he's able to score, but he doesn't want to stand at range like this and allow Balart to close the distance,
don't
get
stop
out, and reset.
And please use your knees. Please, don't kill the time. You have to keep hitting him. You know how you do it. Please. You have you recovered? Yes. Okay.
So Balart's corner imploring him to use the knees in the final 5 minutes. Remember, Balart did predict a flying knee knockout of Alex Silva. But so far tonight, the main weapon for the Cuban has been the overhand left. Certainly not the knees.
Well, the knee's really not going to be there for him. You know, you're going to have to catch Silva coming in or dropping his head down to really connect with that knee. But those leg kicks, that's going to be his most successful weapon here tonight. Laying into those leg kicks to set up those hands, because he's doing good work with it. But Silva's got to start going. He can't just wait there taking pictures in front of Balart like this.
Balart again throwing the overhand left. Silva edging forward, throws a high right roundhouse kick, then drifts back to center circle. Leg kick from Alex. Now a chance for the former world champion.
Great job, caught a mid kick, was able to sweep out the support leg. Let's see what Silva can do here in the last four. Balart so hard to hold on to. Pushes off, gets back to striking.
Fourth left hand there from Gustavo Balart. 1 minute down in the final round, four remaining. Balart circling counterclockwise, fires a left roundhouse kick out of that southpaw stance. Touches him with a left hand and a short right to Alex. Fakes the right leg kick. High head kick from Alex, nicely done. No switch.
Good counter, caught the leg kick on the arm. Boom, came right back with the hook.
Gustavo resets, looking through the brow. Gloves are high for the Cuban. Inside thigh kick, no left hand for company. Alex switching starts. Two punch combination for Gustavo. Again goes body then head.
Alex is gonna go. He can't stand there, getting backed up by Balart. Balart's doing a good job of these blitzes. Coming forward, throwing the leg kick, setting things up, throwing the overhand right, starting to utilize the jab a little bit more.
Oh! And Gustavo Balart does a quick count of his teeth.
That landed flush.
Beautiful work there from Alex Silva.
See, when Alex goes, he scores. Oh, he enters in with it.
These entry elbows, these uppercut elbows, beautifully done from Alex Silva. Can he sustain it though? He's got to up the aggressive meter. Oh, hammer fist strike. Look at the crack the clavicle, downward elbow.
You can tell he's been training with Jing Na, because that is a Jing Na specialty right there with the hammer fist.
Muay Thai clinch from Alex Silva. Can he throw the knees? He shoots down looking for a double leg. Has Gustavo on the canvas now.
Good job as he entered into the single leg. Let's see if he can hold on to him. Balart's got to scramble. Doesn't want to give up all that good work he's done in the first couple rounds.
2 minutes 15 remains. Alex Silva seeming to get his second wind over the last minute or so. Can he sustain it? Don't forget they are judging overall and not as three individual rounds. Inside leg kick. Usually the set for the overhand right. For the overhand left, I should say.
There it is again. He does a great job of holding distance with it. See, that's what Alex needs to do. Pull those elbows when he starts to get close. I would love to see a flying knee too. That's
it. Inside leg kick again from Gustavo, but he's got to throw the hands afterwards. Alex on the outside here. Gustavo's got that left hand cocked and ready.
Pressing there it forward. Goes. Pressing forward, looking for those leg kicks, looking for that big left hand. Alex is disrupted with the jab. When he enters in, throw that jab. He's touching it when he gets the chance. Uh-oh, going for the ride.
Beautifully done, and Alex bounces back up to his feet.
Nice.
Smiles at him, throws out a front kick. Alex looking for the elbow, trying to be unorthodox, trying to be awkward with his striking. Gustavo bouncing, balls to the feet, 1-10 remains. Third and final round. Half his strike, hoping to crack down the collarbone. Downward elbow attempt there from Silva.
He's disguising the elbow with the hammer fist strike. He's bringing the hand up, trying to disguise it, and if he just closed the distance, boom, he's coming forward with the hammer.
New
nice
tricks never
kick.
Seen before from Alex Silva. Can he get another takedown of Gustavo Balart?
You gotta ask, is he doing enough right now? It's really close at this point. That volume striking coming from Balart, but the big power shots, like he landed this big back kick to the face, but is it gonna be enough?
Half a minute remaining now. Balart oozing with confidence, throws that left hand. Alex a right hand lead out of orthodox stance. Balart, big one, but Alex timed it. Puts a punt kick in, round kick there from Balart. Left hand backs off Silva. Balart double leg!
Oh, guillotine. Alex almost jumped to a guillotine right there. Balart gave him his neck. Let's see what he can do here.
El Gladiador! Alex bends to his feet, glances off a knee. Looping right hand there from Gustavo Balart. We are going down to the judges.
It's close. It's close. Adam Caillou picks up Silva. Both athletes believe they've done enough.
How do you score it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, let us know on social media at One Championship. Do you have it, Alex Silva or Gustavo Balart?
Look at this. This was Silva's shining moment of the fight. A spinning kick to the face of Gustavo Balart. That's one for the highlight reel. But then Balart picks him up and takes him down. But Alex popped right back up. I don't know if that counts as a takedown because he popped up so quick, didn't quite get control of the hips right there, but it looked impressive. Entertaining matchup between two top athletes.
Okay, the judges are tabulating the scores. Circle side, no doubt a close contest. Look at the sportsmanship here. Alex Silva and Gustavo Balart, the former world champion and the Olympian. I see Tom Lau now entering the circle. Result in hand. And indeed, let's go to the dapper one to find out our winner.
It's an honor. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of Silva. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of Balart. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision, Gustavo!